Ba ba boom.
Oh yeah.
Boom. Ba ba boom. Say what? Boom. Ba ba boom.
Cool.
Hello and welcome to another The Larry's Pop Pod presents our mini pops. Remember, mini pops are where we take a look at just one subject for about 5 to 7 minutes, kind of go deep on it and help keep our momentum between some of our longer broadcasts. So welcome back. I am Chris Larry, and I'm joined by
Amelia Larry.
And we have another special guest for this week's mini pop, and that is,
hey everybody, it's Mary Larry joining in.
Awesome. So we love having guests here at the Larry's Pop Pod. Actually, it's really important to have a guest today because we're actually going to talk about something that I have not seen or experienced. Yesterday, Mary and Amelia Larry went to the matinee performance of Hamilton on Broadway. And that is going to be the subject for today. So quickly, let's just get some impressions. What was it like?
It was really like a beautiful musical. It was singing and dancing and all the things you would expect from a musical.
Yeah, I would say, wow, believe the hype. This thing really lives up to it. We had been listening to the soundtrack now for the past few months and just, you know, knowing every song in and out. But when you see it come to life on stage, those songs, that singing, that acting, the sets, it is amazing. Really, really go rush and see it if you can.
What were some other observations about this particular musical as opposed to some of the other ones that we've seen, like School of Rock or Matilda or even Wicked? What were some things that you noticed that were different?
In a regular musical or play, it has like dialogue and things in the middle of songs. But in Hamilton, they did song after song.
There's so much singing, rapping. It really just moves so quickly that it does feel like at times, compared to other musicals, that it's like five musicals in one, because the kind of hip-hop pacing of the show, it really speeds along. You'd never feel bored. Isn't that right?
Yeah.
What were some other things that you noticed about this musical? You saw the matinee, correct?
Yeah.
So the scene in the background kind of looked undone because they were kind of still building the government. Like, in the back, some there were, like, higher bricks than others, so they were still kind of building the building.
Oh, so you're saying that through the sets, they were kind of telling the story that the country and the government was still in process of being built.
Exactly.
So those buildings, and they kind of had that visual impression. Oh, that's a great insight.
Yeah, and there were ladders to show that really that Hamilton was at the beginning, and his ideas and his words and his fight for, you know, his beliefs were all being built at that time.
Can you talk about a little bit about the actors and maybe what you noticed there?
Yeah, yesterday at the matinee, we think we had the stand-in.
The understudy?
The understudy, thank you. Yesterday, we noticed we had the understudy who played Hamilton, a guy by the name of, I think I'm saying it right, Hevon McFerrin. This guy was outstanding. Wow. Didn't you root for him, Amelia?
Yeah, he was very good. He knew all of his lines. He expressed the moves that they were supposed to do, and he was just awesome as Alexander Hamilton.
And his singing, right? His rapping was so good. And then also, you know, we have to give a great shout out to the guy who got the most laughs. King George, played by Brian D'Arcy James. Right? He was so funny, wasn't
he?
Yeah. What was his deal, Amelia?
He was kind of like singing the songs that he was like sad for his, was he for England, right?
Yeah, he was the King of England.
And he was kind of like singing because he wasn't going to be the king anymore.
Of America.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. You know, you guys were so excited when you came home. We talked about a lot of different things. What was some of your favorite moments kind of the story and of the musical that kind of were either really emotional or that you really remember that were some of your favorites?
I think the most emotional for me was when their, spoiler alert, when their son died.
Aww.
It was kind of like Alexander Hamilton told him to do something and be brave, but as he did that, he died.
Ugh, and Eliza sang the most beautiful song, and who cried?
Mom.
Mom cried. And I looked over, and you were really emotional, too. It was just this moment where she takes you with her in that stage. It feels so intimate, and you're right there with Eliza in the palm of her hand. I also loved the point where they were, you know, having the cabinet meeting, and instead of dialogue, they actually got to rap their beliefs and ideas at each other. So there you had, you know, Hamilton and Jefferson going back and forth, and they each tried to one-up each other with their raps, and it was pretty cool to see. Hamilton won that round, didn't he?
Yes.
Well, it is his musical. So I noticed, you know, this is obviously about American history. It's not made up. It's not a fictional story. It's nonfiction or a take on nonfiction. What were some things that you learned about history, or maybe some things that you still have questions or want to know more of after watching the musical?
People didn't really know Alexander Hamilton. I mean, I didn't know Hamilton. I don't even know who he was. And now after this musical being so popular that you can't even get a ticket, really, they're doing something to honor him.
And I would say it was great for me, you know, being married to a history buff, kind of going back and learning about the Revolutionary War and how it all started. And I have to say, you know, looking at my daughter and having her be interested in this, not from the standpoint of a classroom, but from an artistic point of view, really is what it's all about, you know, bringing culture up to kids in this way so that they're learning something meaningful. And also at this time in our country, it's a really important thing to go back and learn.
So let's do this as an out question, because we're going to end our mini pop here in the next 45 seconds. If there's one thing you would want to continue to learn more about the starting of our country, about the founding fathers, about that part of American history, what would you want to go and study more based on you seeing this musical?
It's a little weird, but I think I might want to do Alexander Hamilton's, like, early life, like, before he was in the Revolution and, like, maybe when he was first in the Caribbean.
And one thing I just want to shout out is, you know, really exciting is that when they said, you know, immigrants get it done, the whole audience went nuts in New York. We all really felt connected to that, and we wanted to cheer him on and you know, feel the success of an immigrant in America.
All right. Well, thank you, Mary Larry, for being a guest. We hope to have you back with some future topics, kind of filling in for me since I did not get to see the musical. This has been another episode of the Mini Pop presented by the Larry's Pop Pod. We will see you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Rise up. When you're living on your knees, you rise up. Tell your brother that he's got to rise up. Tell your sister that she's got to rise up.
When are these colonies going to rise up? When are these colonies?